Welcome, everybody, to the Streets of Phoenix. I'm Al Joseph.
And I am Christine Uzo.
And we are ready to take you on a ride through the streets of Phoenix.
Yes, it's definitely an all-aboard type of show today as we ride into the world of hip-hop and showcase some amazing aspiring artists right here in the 602.
You know, it's crazy exciting to see how much talent AZ has to offer. So what better place for them to let loose on a mic than right here with us on the streets of Phoenix?
I know, I can't think of a better place, Al, but first, you know what time it is, right?
What time is that, Christine?
It's time to warm up with the party starter himself, DJ I Am Sam, and he brought a special guest for us today, GTK. GTK, how about you show him what we got? Now, I know you guys can't tell because I know he hates being on the camera and all, but Sam, I know even you have to be excited about the complete hip-hop takeover we got going on today. Am I right?
Now, in case y'all are wondering, that was definitely his excited face.
Thank you for the validation there, because I know even he has to be excited about all the talent that we have in the building today.
Yes, indeed. I'm so excited myself that I think I might have to spit a verse or two before the show's over.
Oh, so you a rapper now?
I'm just saying, I think I can feel my flow coming on right about now.
Well, I mean, if you're Jay-Z all of a sudden today, then I must be Nicki.
Whoa. Hold on. Slow down. It sounds like you drank a full glass of Haterade. Now you want to challenge your boy on the mic?
Well, I wasn't saying all that, but now that you're bringing it up.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's officially on. Me and you, do or die, Cypher Challenge. It's going down.
Okay, you mean you're going down, but we'll get to that later. First, we have to get to this Through the Roof lineup, starting with a local rap artist that traveled all over the U.S. performing. Please put your hands together for Dooley KP.
I'm just a country MC. Just
leave the ruler, take y'all back where I'm from.
I'm just a country MC. Take some cash, Paul and G, Bun B and Pimp C, Scarface and Willie D, with some good and more P. Take what they all got, mix it up in the pot. Tell me what do you got? I'm just a country MC. Take some T, double D, T-I-P and G-Z, 3-6, Uncle Luke, JT Money and Weezy. Take what they all got, mix it up in the pot. Tell me what do you got? I'm just a country MC. 993, A-Ball and JG coming out hard. So much admiration and inspiration, that's why they play a big part of my career with them pioneers. So the player list y'all cast. Who knew who when players ball, what my speaker box would last. Licking buckets in my finest fun, till I heard you just gave that dirty money. Now take it off, now let me see it. Underground king, I wanted to be with that front back and side to side. Wood grain off in the ride, candy paint just flossing on the nice wheel of a shine. From 91 through 94, my mind was playing tricks. Talking to my diary about hitting licks. But no more, the thrill's gone, cause my soul food is still standing strong. That's right here, and I'm proud to be this down south for the MC. Take some cash, ball and G, Bun B and Pimp C, Scarface and Willie B, with some good and more B. Take what they all got, mix it up in a pot. Tell me what do you got, I'm just a country MC. Take some T, double D, T-I-P and G-Z, 3-6, Uncle Luke, JT Money and Weezy. Take what they all got, mix it up in a pot. Tell me what do you got, I'm just a country MC. They say I was too live, nasty as I wanted to be. That's why I was hard, bouncing to the beat while with Captain D. Just like JT, I had a poison plan. I hated those, they hated me, and they didn't understand. And just when they thought that they had me, I figured out here comes the tanks with no limit. Rolling straight to the top, screaming on me, body, body. Told you that be riding, riding. Freak the bowl like Mr. Cole. Looking for the man right here. With a block side, 400 degrees, I am my cash money. I won't fire with bling bling, I am my number one stunt. With a 10 club, I'll throw the late night tip with the motivator. Working hard, a long guard, cause MC's here. Show hate with fast, ballin' deep, bun, B, and BMC. Scarface and Willie B, with some good M.O.P. Take what they all got, mix it up in a pot. Tell me what do you got, I'm just a country MC. Take some G, double D, T.I.P. and G.Z. 3-6, Uncle Luke, J.T. Money and Weezy. Take what they all got, mix it up in a pot. Tell me what do you got, I'm just a country MC. I'm doing this for the thug, cause you're no nanny. We take it to the highs. And shut up every creep. Introduce to the crook. Introduce to the trap. Gave the thugs motivation and made the big snap. Doing crime in the field, so you know we mobbed deep. Them young bloods don't get war, can't care less you shit. Double talk, then we're purple on that presidential early. When I'm out riding clean, they're trying to catch me riding dirty. Cause every day I'm hustling and I'm so hood. Ain't no more playing GA, and I hope it's understood. Might get your wig split, cause I'm never scared. Stop acting like a be a roll out and be well, yeah.
We'll be right back with this guy right here in the living room, so keep it logged.
With our first guest, Dooley KP. So welcome to the show.
Glad to be here.
Now, Dooley KP, as a local artist, you had opportunity to do shows in several other cities. What has the opportunity been like for you?
It's been great, you know, just performing has always been a part of my life. I've been doing it since I was 6. So anytime I get a chance to entertain the crowd, is always good for me. That's what I like to do, so.
Nice, nice. So when did you feel like this is something that I want to pursue?
I would say after football was over with, torn MCL, went off to college and came back. It was like, hey, it's just time to pursue music full time, and that's what I did.
And I know sometimes you'll see parents will caution their kids from getting involved in this. What about hip hop has made you want to pursue this?
I mean, for me, it was always different because it wasn't just hip hop. It always been music itself. So as a child, I imitated any and everybody from Michael to Hammer to Cube to anybody. So my parents really didn't allow us to listen to a certain kind of music, but we would do it anyway behind their back or whatnot. And then after they see that I can do it, I started writing poems. But after that, they kind of just said, okay, since he's been doing this for a while, let's go ahead and see what he can do.
I think you just answered my question, but aside from the people you just named, who else was like some of the biggest musical influences on you growing up?
All music in general, pretty much, but as far as my career goes, it would have to be Pac, of course. Being from the South, you know, we got a lot of pioneers that way. I had Outkast, 8-Ball MJG, UGK, even expanded to as far as the West Coast with Dre. Being that they was business owners, I liked the people that was on their own companies that gave me a kind of idea with Easy, what he was doing. Luke did it with 2 Live Crew and then his record company, and then, you know, just anybody in music in general.
Awesome, awesome. And I know you have a few projects going on in the works right now, and you're going to give us one more dose of KP later on. How can Phoenix find you and see what you got going on?
Pretty much just Google me. I mean, everything is a Dooley KP, except for my SoundCloud. It's Dooley KP 229, you know. But, yeah, I am working on a few projects. Actually, I'm on tour right now, currently in the process. We did actually a New Mexico show. It was great, so got a lot of things coming up. I'm releasing the EP, The Royal Sweet Life. That's the actual new, I'm working down in Miami, gonna work with some major producers with Don Mega, who's also part of D-Block and Atlantic Records, so they trying to give me 5 records. So I'm flying down to Miami probably in May, and we gonna try to finish the project.
Ooh. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, Dooley KP. You wanna check him out? We have some more coming up on the show, so sit tight. We'll be right back.
Central Super Club is now conveniently located at 3110 North Central. Again, that's 3110 North Central. With all the top-of-the-line amenities, top-notch food, famous chicken wings, top-shelf drinks, along with the exclusive VIP booth to complement your all-star night. And don't forget to capture the moment with yours truly, Curtail the photographer. Again, that's 3110 North Central. Tell them 3D Central.
We are back in the living room, and our next guest is turning heads and making noise as he breaks into the hip-hop scene. Please welcome Hunter James Pabst.
So, Hunter, it's kind of tough for you since you haven't really put your music out there in a while, and you're trying to build and support a fan base. What has that process been like for you?
Oh, it's been fun. Because I used to rap with a group when I was younger, and it kind of fell apart. You know, we built up a little bit of a fan base and started rocking some shows around this valley and everything. But it fell apart, and I wanted to do it by myself. I wanted to prove to myself that I was as independent as every artist wants to be. So the process is just grinding it out, honestly. It's real simple. Just put out as much as I can and make sure everybody knows this face, you know?
Hey.
So I know you went to school to be an audio engineer. So what do you prefer, being on the mic or behind the scenes making the music?
Oh, on the mic, of course. Like, a lot of people think, like, I just want attention, and that's not at all the case. Not at all. I went through the process of audio engineering, and it was fun, and I learned a lot. But it wasn't anything that, like, was passion for me. I mean, it was just money. I mean, that's never what I was raised to be, as a money chaser, nothing like that. So I always found my passion and expression, and I was like, regardless of how much money I spent on school and how much in debt I am, I'm gonna still follow my dream and just do what I want to do, you know?
Amen to that. What's the process for your music and your lyrics? Like, what's the motivation behind it?
Honestly, what we hear on the radio, like, the first song I ever heard was Big Things Poppin' by T.I., and one of the few after that was Superstar by Lupe Fiasco, and I don't know, man. It just hit my soul, and I was like, I like people who talk about real topics that everybody can relate to. I can't relate to you talking about whipping in a Benz and you got four girls sitting in the back. I can't relate to that because, one, not many girls like me, and two, I don't have enough money for a Benz. So I got my little busted F-150, and I'd rather talk about that because more people can relate to that. I mean, people can see eye to eye with that.
Nice. So we're going to change tunes a little bit here. And I know rappers, they usually love the attention that they get from the ladies. Okay?
Yeah.
And I know you probably get your fair share. So let us know. Are you single, relationship, wife? Come on.
We
all want to
know.
It's a little bit complicated
in
one situation, I would say. But overall, I guess I would say single. Like,
one of those.
I would say single.
Awesome. So you ever use your famous name, I have a famous beer name. You ever use that to your advantage, get the girls?
man, I could, honestly. I could say, hey, you want a Pabst? And I'm not just talking me. Like, I could, I'm only 20, so I could give you the money to go buy the beer. I can't buy
beer,
it for you.
And then we can share it.
But, no, yeah, I usually play it cool because, honestly, my last name's not supposed to be Pabst. It's supposed to be Jernigan, but I think my eighth great grandpa just changed it. To this day, I don't know why, but
I had a quick question. So you said you're only 20. What do you see yourself in like a year or two from now in the future with your music?
Honestly, with music, like, it's not really about numbers for me at all. Like, if I'm still in this position next year, that's fine as long as my content has elevated. Like, I want to be better as an artist by this time next year, but if I still have 10 likes on Facebook, I'm fine with that. You know what I'm saying? Like, as long as I'm not on this level talent-wise next year, then I'm totally fine with whatever numbers are coming in. If I'm still rocking shows with three people in the crowd, that's all good.
Nice. So when we come back, we're going to see Hunter James make some magic on the mic. So come on back.
Hey.
Thank you.
This song is like my baby.
I had a premonition, my lyrical exposition will occur in my next exhibition. My fights against the devil got me feeling like I'm Holyfield against Tyson, but I'll win through my indictment. My prosperous writing, igniting, liking with phosphorus, not to just relate through substandard economics. And situations don't just sound like knives I trust. Got to touch, lost, I found souls through my vocal cords to the populace. I was heard suitably at the top. Through my father's title, now living frugally, half the shop. Usually with little guap and food to be all I cop. But I'm still making it through with these, thanks to my pops. And yo, he brought me money for the monthly, so some see that I ain't struggling. I ain't hustling like I'm living comfortably. Nah, I push myself out of the comfort zone to touch a soul and heart like my hand was molar rams. Yeah, I'm trying to raise the bar like a shoulder press. Not my words, but people been known to check my statements and see that I have little financial complications. Thinking I'm making it rain, but they just seeing condensation. Yeah, this is dedication. I sold my soul to God. He invested in this music, his destiny. I go through it. This is dedication. I'm sick of 9 to 5s, like I'm paying the reps. I'm fixing to win and rise and shine. This is dedication. I'm hearing what they're saying. I see the faces that they're making, scoffing at my situation. This is dedication. Regardless of my placement, who I choose to soul was here with, I'm training to take it. I strengthened my heart, peace from the start until I turned 18 and the hardship started raising their sails. The masses got me sitting in classes backwards because of an issue for staying in colleges for everyone and vice versa. I hear another preaching that nonsense, I might hurt ya. Chocking dropouts, I got a militia that like to murk ya. I didn't drop out, that would make my attendance an even greater waste. But young star, forget what the majors say. If college is for you, that's something you should go through with dedication. But if it ain't, middle finger to those saying, switch your lane and find your own education. Yeah, cause you lead your own life, own journey, own team. Make your own goal, create your own dream. Building on small wins to boost your whole esteem until they equate to the greatest victory, lifting your whole team. I sold my soul to God, he invested in this music, his destiny, I go through with it. This is dedication, I'm hearing what they're saying. I see the faces that they're making, scoffing at my situation. This is dedication, I'm sick of 9 to 5s, like I'm paying the rest. I'm fixing to win and rise and shine. This is dedication, regardless of my placement, who I choose to associate with, I'm training to take it through dedication.
Hold up, hold up. Oh, don't think I'm done yet.
Yo, hey. Love to the ones who show it back, none to the ones whose actions lack. Love to those who feel my train of thought, none to the ones whose intent is to derail these tracks. I thought I told y'all this is dedication. Through the pages of 4 agreements, I found my meditation, mental peace. Now day by day, I hustle getting out my dreams. This is dedication. The judgments of others' attempts to corrupt my serenity, saying the only way I'm doing it cause I was born into wealth plentifully. But while they measure my G's, they should measure my heart. It's left on my sleeve. Come on. This is dedication. I sold my soul to God. He invested in this music, his destiny. I go through it. This is dedication. I'm sick of 9 to 5s, like I'm paying the reps. I'm fixing to win and rise and shine. This is dedication. I'm hearing what they're saying. I see the faces that they're making, scoffing at my situation. This is dedication. Regardless of my placement, who I choose to associate with, I'm training to take it through dedication.
My name is Hunter James.
What? I think I found my new crush, y'all. Give it up for Hunter James.
Michael's at Park Central Super Club is now conveniently located at 3110 North Central. Again, that's 3110 North Central. With all the top-of-the-line amenities, top-notch food, famous chicken wings, top-shelf drinks, along with the exclusive VIP booth to complement your all-star night. And don't forget to capture the moment with yours truly, Kurt Till the photographer. Again, that's 3110 North Central. Tell them 3D Central.
We're back, and you know it wouldn't be a show if we didn't check in with the Razor and get his take on what hip-hop can do for you. So get your pencils and paper out for those notes, because it's time for a little Chalk Talk.
Hello, everyone. In today's special edition of Chalk Talk, we're going to take a little break from the locker room and show you how the Razor uses hip-hop music as motivation to attack a workout. Let's get started. Essential to every workout, we gotta get started with a warm-up.
VIP. Let's kick it. And listen, I sit back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly, flow like a harpoon daily and nightly.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance, crush the speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly, when I play a dope melody, anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it, you better gain weight. You better hit bullseye, the kid don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it.
After the warm up, now it's time to attack that workout.
X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it
come
to
on.
Ya. First we gonna rock, then we gonna fall, then we let it pop, don't let it go.
Come on.
X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it
hey
to
yo,
ya.
Hey yo, where am I at?
I know I got them down in the keys, give them love and they give it back. Talk too much for too long.
What?
Don't give up, you're too strong.
What?
Love to the wild, wild hunters. Shout out to that done it. And it ain't even about the dough. It's about getting down for what you stand for, yo. For real.
We gonna rock, then we gonna fold.
Then we let it pop, don't let it go.
Come on.
X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to
come
ya
on.
First we gonna rock, then we gonna fold. Then we let it pop, don't let it go.
Come on.
X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it
come
to
on.
Ya. First we gonna rock, then we gonna fold. Then we let it pop, don't let it go. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya.
Alright, after an intense workout, gotta protect those muscles. Time to shut it down.
Girls ain't got nothing on you. Say baby, I had to mention that if you were a star, you'd be the one I'm searching for. Other girls, they got attention, but I just always feel like they're in need of something.
Thanks to hip-hop, that keeps the vessel looking nice and tight. So turn on some music, get out there and make it happen.
Wow, I am still trying to figure out some of those moves, but I took some notes and I'm gonna work on it. Y'all got about 2 minutes to practice as well, and come on back. We got more show on the way. Stay tuned. Not only an inspiration to the hip-hop community, but anyone with a heartbeat. Please welcome Trill Dill and Cali Plus, otherwise known as Falling Atmosphere.
Well, thank you. What's up, guys?
Hey, how's it going?
Welcome to the show. We're so glad to have you guys here today.
Thank you.
Now, in the world we live in, where there's a lot of presumptions and judgments made about people, and then the world seeing two young white guys, and then they see a guy in a wheelchair, and they think, oh, they know nothing about hip-hop. How do y'all respond to that?
Well, people who know me personally know what happened, but I used to always be around the hip-hop community. All my friends were really into basketball when I moved here from South Africa, so I instantly started listening to rap my entire life. Started like freestyling at 12, rapping at 12, just a hobby and everything. Then when I was 15, I was actually diagnosed with this condition in my spine, which affects my walking coordination in my nervous system. So it really took a toll on my life, was progressive. So I found out about this at 15, and I got the wheelchair at 17. when I was becoming too hard to manage and everything, but I started having so much time because I couldn't play basketball anymore. So I kind of started using that toward making music and going to the studio whenever I can and promoting it and getting other people to hear my story.
Yeah, and when it comes to people like, you know, I mean, obviously we don't look like your typical hip-hop group, but that's why I know we kind of just let the music speak for itself. Like, we don't try to make music that doesn't sound like it come from us necessarily, and like that's why it's kind of like when we were talking earlier about lyrical content and making stuff that actually means things, that's we got a good story to go with and a good way to, you know, use hip-hop to tell a different, you know, go through a different point of view through hip-hop, you know, rather than your normal, you know, like gang violence or drugs and all that. We just kind of respond using our own way of hip-hop, I guess.
Nice, nice. Now, Nick, I know you mentioned that you were diagnosed at 15, and how did you, overcome or just kind of get inspired to get involved in this industry and not let that kind of prohibit your dreams?
Well, I just knew, like, I needed to do something in my life. I couldn't give up from there. So I used all the effort that I had to make music because I always loved hip-hop. I was a rapper way before I got in the wheelchair, but now that I got put in a wheelchair, it, like, gave me a lane, an extra way of, like, telling people my story, extra way of inspiring people to get through whatever they have going on in their life and use it.
What kind of projects do you guys have right now in the making, if you guys have any at all?
Yeah, we just released our fourth project called Young Masterminds. It's a 13-song project. I did all the production on it and edited a mix, and he did all the writing and rapping as well. We have a few features on there. It's available on SoundCloud. Our SoundCloud is Falling Atmosphere Music. But yeah, that's our number one project right now. We're really pushing it. And as far as new music, we're always, you know, creating, brainstorming for the next stuff. But right now, we're really focused on Young Masterminds and very happy with the product that we put out with.
Very, very nice. We are very excited to see what you guys have for us today as far as performance-wise. How about you tell us where Phoenix can find you, all your social media outlets?
Yeah, so, I mean, we're available on Instagram under Falling Atmosphere, Twitter, DFA Music. Then we have YouTube. Bo Horiza films and directs all of our music videos. So we have, I think, like 7 or 8 music videos out on YouTube. And then SoundCloud is where you're going to find all our music, and Spotify. And hopefully within this next month, we'll have Young Masterminds on Spotify.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Falling Atmosphere right here. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Yeah, thank you. This song is called Where Do We Go, featuring Catherine Collins, and it's off our new project, Young Masterminds.
Some say I'm hysterical, others say I'm a miracle. What's your principle? Me, I'm Mark Wahlberg, invincible.
Pronounce every syllable.
Paint a visual. Call us lasagna. We're always baked.
Betty
girl on a cabana. Girl on a
date,
chill like Smirnoff in a
cooler.
Skip school like Ferris Bueller. I'm the cooler cougar, a trooper,
real fly immigrant.
Yeah, ignorant to think she don't want me.
So we smoked on a hill like one tree. Took her to my country.
Told her to stay like Rihanna.
Rihanna.
Never leave like marijuana.
Marijuana.
Don't sweat it like a sauna. Look on her face and say you'll be my Madonna.
Too much care for one person.
Where do we go
from here?
Where do we go
from here? I thought I figured out what love was.
Yeah.
Where do we go from here?
Where do we go
from here? Through all times of grief and mourning.
Where do we go from here?
That night to remember. It feels like summer in December. She wants commitment, but but I'm not ready. I can take a hint. She wants to go steady. She springs in summer and falls in winter. I'd settle if it weren't for Melinda. I let Melinda's harden. We met in kindergarten. I've seen her since she started high school. Take it day by day. That's my rule. One day we'll dance like electronica by beach house in Santa Monica. Hear the harmonica, the sound that really touches. I found love in abundance. Guitars and trumpets, your love is my substance.
Too much care for one person.
Where do we go
from here?
Where do we go
from here?
I thought I figured out what love was.
Who do I
know from here?
Where
do we go from here?
Through all times
of grief and mourning.
Yeah.
Who do I know out there?
Who do I know out there?
I miss your grace every morning.
Where do we go from here?
Where do we go from here?
Once again, guys, I'm Trill Dill. I make all these beats.
Kelly Plus, rapper.
Together, we're Fallen Atmosphere.
Hey, that's what's up, y'all. Falling Atmosphere, everybody. We'll be right back.
Michael's at Park Central Super Club is now conveniently located at 3110 North Central. Again, that's 3110 North Central. With all the top-of-the-line amenities, top-notch food, famous chicken wings, top-shelf drinks, along with the exclusive VIP booth to complement your all-star night. And don't forget to capture the moment with yours truly, Cartel the Photographer. Again, that's 3110 North Central. Tell them 3D Central.
With so much ongoing discussion around hip-hop and its influence on today's society, we thought we'd let our amazing guests, as hip-hop artists themselves, join D in the VIP den, because it's time for Phoenix to chime in.
Thanks, Al. Yo, we are up in the VIP den. My guests need no introduction. I got some of the hip-hop artists guests on with me today, and today we're going to dig into the trenches about hip-hop. We're gonna talk about, are they going in, is it going in the right direction or is it going in the wrong direction? But you know how we like to do in the streets of Phoenix, though. We like to play a little guessing game. You know how we do. We're gonna start over here on the end. We're gonna start with Hunter James. Do we think that he's positive or negative about hip hop? We'll see. Moving on. All right, so what do we think about Dooley? All right. Let's check it out with Trill Dill.
Yes, sir.
What do we think, positive or negative?
Negative.
All right. And what do we think about Cali Plus? Positive. All right. Let's get them to reveal their answers real quick. Let's start over here. What do you got for me?
Oh, man.
What was that? Positive?
Positive.
All right, we're going to talk to him a little bit later. Let's move on down the line. What do we got? Positive. Yeah, we definitely want to talk. What do we got?
I go positive.
I think they're gonna support their they're gonna support their artistry. What do we got? Positive. We fo-fo-fo. Yeah. All right. So since you're saying that hip hop is going into a positive direction, what is it that you believe or think or why it's going in that direction?
I think with a lot of artists breaking through into the mainstream radio, being conscious rappers, like I know Macklemore is kind of on his funny stuff now, you know,
right.
But he broke through with Same Love and other artists as such, like Lupe Fiasco getting on there. I mean, there's a lot more diversity than there's ever been.
True.
So I think we're kind of breaking the monotonous, same old, and we're getting some diversity, and I think that's a huge plus.
Yeah. What do you
I think it's a plus due to the fact that it gives people on the street an opportunity to do something with themselves, not just actually think about what they could have been doing, just a lot of negative things. They could have actually been, you know, still in the streets doing drugs or anything of that nature, behind bars. A lot of them actually becoming businessmen, so own independent companies. So right. I think it's actually went into a positive for as far as everybody was signing deals and things of that nature, where everybody owned their own rights and, you know, just grew.
Okay. What do you think?
Yeah, I said positive because I think right now hip-hop's at its most accepting stage.
Okay.
Kind of like how you were saying with Macklemore's Same Love Song, there's kind of more topics that are more bigger topics where people are hitting with hip-hop.
Right.
And I think musically, they're incorporating a lot more live instruments rather than just sampling how it used to be. So
true.
Musically, it's advancing as well.
Yeah, I agree with that. You know, I just think about some of the hip-hop that I grew up with and some of the negative connotations that it had with it. And you're right. And, you know, you don't have a lot of diversity. You know, it stuck to one culture and one type of rap. You know, you're like, dang, for real? That's what you're talking about? You out there really doing that out in the streets? But let's move over.
So I also think, like, it's going a positive direction. I think 5 years ago wasn't that good, but I think the direction's getting better now because there's a lot of artists that have substance in the music, okay, actually stand for something. And I'm in the game now.
You know what? Those are really good answers. Like, I couldn't think of anything else to go against that. You know, but I think about the negative effects that it's had on society. You know, we talk about a lot of hip hop artists that objectify women, that, you know, promote violence and things like that. Do you think that that's something that's still happening now, where we're doing that, or do you want to see more of that culture you're saying, where it's diversified, or what do you feel like? Do you think that's something that has to keep hip hop going, you know, to talk about those things?
Right. I think that's always going to be around, because sadly, we got to accept that it's kind of life, you know?
Right.
It's just something that we got to deal with, you know? But the nice thing is, if we can dumb that down a little bit and not make it as prevalent,
right,
I don't think that's always a bad thing, you know? Like, sometimes you need a negative to appreciate more positives, you know?
True.
It sucks, you know? Sometimes you got to bring people down, but that's overall what lifts us all up even further, you know?
Yeah. Okay. Same question for you.
I would say it's our actual outlet, or say news media.
Right.
A lot of young people don't watch Channel 6 or Channel 10 news, so they don't get a lot of the actual downside, only what they see.
Right.
So it's going to be around, like you said, this is part of life. But you, like I said, as far as the women part, I mean, yeah, you can kind of definitely dumb that down, because you respect the women. Women are queens, and, you know, you don't want to keep just
right.
making them feel, you know, down on themselves and not yeah. having any kind of self-esteem. So that part, but definitely, but as far as the actual the violence and things of that nature, it's just what the world we live in. So it's
yeah.
always going to be there.
It's
but
always going to be.
It's just
yeah.
that
report. I definitely agree with that. It's always going to be, you know, something that someone's going to come out and feel like, well, this is how I have to, you know, I have to express myself. This is what I live daily life. I'm like, you live in the suburbs. You got vans and you got kids and stuff. I'm like, you ain't out there. When I go out there, I'm going to shoot them up. No, you not. You're going to go home, you're going to have you some cocoa, and you're going to watch some Tyler Perry or something. Same question for you.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's easier to, if you don't want to listen to that type of music, it's easier to stray away from it. I think, like, they don't necessarily play those songs on the radio if you're into just the, you know, mainstream yeah. hip-hop version of it. So, like, you kind of have to go out and find that more harder violence gain stuff, like you kind of know which artists are doing that, and you,
right.
it's easier to stay away from that.
Right.
But I think it's always has to be talked about. Like, every kind of issue needs to be, or else we're not raising awareness about it. People
True.
Aren't really. It's just kind of it's gonna be there, but there's definitely a lot more to talk about these days.
Definitely and, agree with that.
As far as like violence goes, it's always been, always will, like they said, but I think it's important to get people to know about things, because most people aren't going to know about the bad parts of the world.
Right.
So it's good to raise awareness about that.
Yeah.
Get those stories and perspectives
yeah.
in people's heads. And then as far as women goes, like, I love women. I think all music talks about women.
Right.
I mean, yeah. If it's degrading to them, like, I see why it could be offensive, but that's just like, it's culture, you know.
You just think it's just.
It's just the way someone says something.
It relates to some of their listeners or their fans or things like that.
Yeah.
You don't think that they're really out there, like when they see their mom or when they see their girlfriend, yo. Get over here right now, though.
Yeah, like, if there's just something degrading, I don't think, like, they're thinking all women are this way.
True. Yeah, I think that sometimes it is really the artist, and they're in that moment, and they're just like, okay, well, this is the persona that I have to put out there. This is the persona that I want to put it out there, and that's not really the lifestyle that I'm living. So since we're saying it's going in a positive way, what do you feel about the ones that, I mean, they're still doing positive music, but there's no storyline behind it. It's just the beat, and it's, you know, like, I put my hand, you know, just some random stuff. I'm like, that's that bubblegum stuff? Yeah, what do you guys feel about that? I mean, do you feel like it, like hip-hop should have some more substance rather than just like a dance track?
Yeah. I really do feel like it does, but the nice thing is we're finally getting into that positive realm.
Right.
So it's a start. Like, we're taking baby steps right now, but I mean, as long as we get to further progress.
Yeah.
Like, if we get back to that storytelling, like what we grew up with.
Yeah.
But if we get it in a positive manner, I'm fine with hip hop staying right there.
Right there.
Like,
right.
Don't
there.
Move. Stand still.
Yeah.
I feel like hip hop is just. For those who actually are hip-hop heads, it's a 360 spin in a circle, because before hip-hop had storytelling, that's what it was.
Right.
You had hip-hop. Right. I mean, Busy B was really a rapper.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? These guys really just got it in and appealed to the DJ and got the crowd started, put your hands and wave them around like you don't care, things of that nature. So it just got back to that. People got tired of hearing the actual negative and, you know, got back to, like you said, a positive side. So, but you're going to have some storytellers come around. And like I said, I'm a big fan of some of the J. Cole, Big Crit. You know what I'm saying? And
yeah.
Some of them guys that really actually deep down and tell some stories behind their music and relay a message, because that's what I grew up on.
I'm definitely, storytelling. Definitely. Yeah, that's what I listen for. Yeah.
Once again, it was just like a 360. So you're just going to come back around. It's going to keep coming back around. It's all according to your niche.
Right.
And, you know, and what you do. And in these days, you got the club bangers. Everybody want to be in the party. Everybody want to be in a good mood. So when you're doing music.
No, I mean, it definitely is a moneymaker type of deal. You know, I'm going to put this little dance track out here real quick.
That's
you
what
know,
it is.
I release a single. Boom.
And
yeah.
You say two words. Lil Jon had three words. He made off $1 million. Yeah, what is. Uh-huh. Okay, so, you know.
Same question for you.
I think right now, like kind of how he was saying, 5 years ago, hip-hop wasn't. Where it's at now, we kind of took a weird break of good music, and there's a lot more one-hit wonders. Like, if you remember the song, like, Cash Out?
Yeah.
And, like, the song Racks on Racks on Racks. Like, you don't hear, you know, those guys don't put out music anymore, because that was the label that wrote the track. Yeah. It was meant for that. Right now, everyone cares about lyrics, and people care about bars, and even the club songs these days have actual lyrical, like, content.
I love a good punchline, just a good punchline that'll catch me from left. I'm like, say what?
Yeah. Yeah, triple entendres and all that stuff.
I'm like, I'm gonna use that one day. All right, so but I'm gonna let you answer and then we're gonna move on.
Well, yeah, I think it's positive too, again, because like I feel it's good to have a good variety of serious songs with material. Then at clubs you can pop and like dance to, have a good time too. Everyone wants to let go. Everyone also wants to hear about stuff on a bad day, like how they can relate and get through their problems.
Right. Well, there you have it. Kanye, yo, hit a brother up. Facebook, tweet, I got you, bro. You can log in and join in the conversation, streetsofphoenix.com. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. We want to keep it going and check in with Renee, who polled our very own Streets of Phoenix to see just how well they know their hip-hop. Check it out.
So, we are here with the Streets of Phoenix, and we're going to ask you just a few questions, okay? So, Marcus at Go, name your top five female rappers of all time. Go. 20 seconds, by the way.
Kim.
Little Kim.
I don't want to throw Nicki Minaj in there.
Five, four, three, two. All right, so we had Little Kim and Nicki Minaj. Okay. All right, now. I'm gonna start the song and then you finish it. Don't drop that. he had it. Yes, yes, yes. He knows it. Okay. Last question. I'm gonna ask you to do a dance. No, come on. You know this one. I'm gonna start it and then you can do the dance, alright? No watch me whip. No watch me. You know this one. You don't know this one. You don't know the name? That's alright. What's your name?
Isaiah.
Priscilla. I'm Renee. Thank you so much for being on the streets of Phoenix. Say hi.
Karen,
I'm Renee. Welcome to the streets of Phoenix. So just a few questions for you. First question, who would you say had the biggest rap rivalry, East Coast, West Coast, of all time?
I would say Biggie Smalls and
Tupac and Biggie. All right. Next, I'm going to start the song and then I need you to finish it.
Okay.
Now watch me whip.
Now watch me name.
Okay. And last thing, do you know how to dab?
No.
Okay. What about twerk?
Yes, but we won't be doing that.
We will not be doing that today on the Sabbath day. We're keeping it holy. Amen. All right. Well, thank you so much, Human of God, for being with us today.
You're very welcome.
All right. So, Adam, just a few quick questions for you. Who to you is the top rapper of all time?
Top rapper of all time. I listen more to Eminem than anybody else.
Okay. Start the song and then you finish it for me.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Okay.
I like big.
What's
it? Winning! You said you didn't know anything about hip hop.
I don't know anything about hip hop.
What we're gonna do is ask you some hip hop questions. How much do you know about hip hop? Little bit?
A little bit? I listen to like underground music.
Okay. Alright, so who would you say is the greatest male rapper of all time?
Suicide Boys.
Alright now, Suicide Boys. Okay, now I'm gonna start the song and then you finish it. Okay? I know when that hotline bling.
I don't even know that song.
Awesome. Now watch me whip.
No,
okay, you got that one. Last one. Bling! Can you twerk?
I don't know how to twerk.
Listen. Can you hit the Quan?
I don't think so.
Let me see it. Dab. Hey! Perfect. Thank you so much for being on our show. All right, you think about the hip hop drama. Who is the best rapper in your opinion?
In my opinion, Q-Tip.
Oh, okay. Q-Tip. I'm gonna start the song and then you finish it.
I'm the last person on earth.
You think so?
I just like to stop.
Okay.
I'm not
Q-Tip song, just any song. You ready? I like big. You know it?
Uh-huh.
I like big butts that I cannot laugh. Okay, alright, so you didn't know that one. Last thing. Can you twerk?
I can barely walk.
Hey man. All right, we try. Can you dab for me? Can you dab?
I can do this.
All right, now, different kind of dab. So, can you show me how to dab? Oh, right here. Only on the streets of Phoenix. You know what? Let's do this one. In 20 seconds, name the top five male rap artists. Go.
Oh, what? That I like?
Yeah, right now. Top five.
Let's see. Daz, Razzcast, Jadakiss, Drake, Kendrick Lamar.
All right, now we got somebody who really knows hip hop here. All right. Daz.
Oh, it is.
Hey!
All right.
Got Vicky and Larry with us here live on the streets of Phoenix, and they're gonna help me out and answer couple of questions. Can you tell me who the top five male rappers are? 20 seconds. Top five.
Not a clue. Not my job.
I haven't heard of that rapper. Ever.
Not my
job. I'm going to look him up. All right, so not a clue. That's cool. What about this song? Do you know this song? I know when that hotline bling. No! Awesome! We are two for two.
Well,
this is great.
Right. Genre for me.
That's all right. That's all right. So, here's what I'm going to have you guys do. Do you watch football?
No.
All right, you watch football. All right, now. Do you know the dance that Cam Newton did after every game? Can you do that? Can you guys do that right now? Was who?
I said the only one I knew of was Vanilla Ice.
All right!
Score!
That's 20 years ago. That's all right. That's all right. You guys, thank you so much. And there you have it, folks. Never, ever a dull moment here on the streets of Phoenix. And apparently, we're still working on our hip-hop knowledge here in AZ. But you know what? Must mean the next great rapper is going to come out of Arizona. So, with that being said, please log on to Streets of Phoenix, www.streetsofphoenix.com. Let us know what you have going on so we can bring the Streets of Phoenix to you.
He's back with another special performance for us today in the coffee house. Let's hear it one more time for Hunter James.
This is nothing but a lyrical monster. Honestly, they want to realize my chakra, but this is my mantra. Live positive, think positive. I got it tatted on my skin. I'm doing everything I want with every single whim. See, honestly, I have never been a wimp. I just been a brother that was a bit of a simp. Used to be chasing money. I thought it was funny. I was living bummy. And now I'm all of a sudden realizing that I was living crummy. So I'm trying to get something. I want opposite of nothing. I want everything. See, honestly, I got a little bit, but I need better things. I want to be the best to be. See, honestly, everybody say that Hunter James is never gonna be wrecking beats, but honestly, you have to check the speech because nobody else wreck it like me. See, I'm so sick, they say I got type B, hepatitis. Ooh, dang, sick with addiction. This is never fiction. This is the demolition of the game that we are realizing. Honestly, too many lies in hip hop. See, I'm taking this from beauty salons back to thrift shops. And if you thinking that this not off the TOP, you might as well see your king D.I.E. But I'm rapping until I meet freaking G.O.D. because your peace hopefully will reach into your M.I. to the N.D. I see a lot of brothers looking like the alphabet, they N.V. But honestly, these cheesy brothers, to compared to them, I am greater. Don't get that, then you need to think greater. See, honestly, my flow has been tailored, and I'm gonna do it major even though I'm independent. I'm so relentless, no matter what, I'm never dependent on other brothers that just wanna get mentions on Twitter. Man, they always thinking they understand the bigger picture, but they thinking they got the chicken dinner, but that doesn't make them a winner. Cause really, KFC is the one that kills us. Honestly, I'll never have to pop no pills, bruh. I deal with my stress sober, cause I'm the microphone controller, and no matter what, this freestyle will never be over. We gonna be here until midnight. Boy, this site is past 2020. If you thinking that's a lie, then you real freaking funny. See, nobody else on this MIC can touch me except for Arizona rappers, cause I'm finally putting this on the map, bruh.
We got audience shoutouts coming up. This is Hunter James, y'all.
It's your boy GTK, Gibby the Kid. Just want to give a quick shout out to my team with Shine Management. It goes for De La Preem, The Rena, ID, list goes on, as well as Truminati, Eddie Wells, what's up, man? Salty Brazzi, the whole squad. Make sure you guys follow me on social media, just about everywhere at That Kid Give. That's THATKIDGIBB. Peace.
I want to give the biggest thank you to my mom and my dad and my little brother, my biggest inspiration. Also, thank you to Justin for being my engineer, my boys Nick, Andrew, Drew, Culver, Chris, Brandon, thank all of y'all for the inspiration. You can find me anywhere at Hunter James Only.
I want to give a quick shout out to Jean Republic. It's the studio we record at, and I'm able to mix all of our tracks at as well. If you guys need any place to record or like any beats or anything, go ahead and check out that team at JohnRepublic.com.
I want to give a shout out to all the Beamsville Sluggers, Beamsboy Entertainment, and everybody that's supporting Dula KP. While we're out doing our thing, you can catch me. Just Google Dula KP, you'll find them.
Shout out to my barber.
Well, we had another amazing show today. We want to thank all of our guests.
Whoa. Hold on. Wait a minute. Time out. Now, I know you ain't trying to wrap the show without going down in the Cypher Challenge and promise the people.
You really trying to do this right now, Al?
Do I? Can I get all my guests real quick to back me up on this one? You know, I hate to do this, but you was hating on me earlier today, so I got to let people know.
Well, I mean, if you're really trying to do this right now, then let's go.
Hey, yo, DJ, give me that beat. Yeah. Look, my name is Al Joseph, and yeah, I got the mostest. I gotta teach Christina a lesson while my mother is open. I'm bringing heat, cause you know I got some mad skills. So sit tight, I got you, mama, let daddy pay the bills. Cause these rhymes and my flow, they bringing paper. You see she's scared now, but really?
Yeah, they call me Uzo. I know you think I'm sweet. I never called you, but this dude trying to send for me. Now I'm swerving and serving you like it's Mickey D's. So who's scared now, me? Man, please. I'm raining threes on the mic. Call me Steph Curry. I know you already sad, so let me try to hurry. Remember, I didn't start it, but now I gotta end this. And your response? That's right, silence.
Okay. She got me on this round, but I'm already plotting for my next comeback. I want to give a special thanks to Dooley KP, Falling Atmosphere, Hunter James Pass, and to all our house guests. Because here, we're not just a talk show, but...
GTK? It's dance cam time.
Ooh, welcome to the streets of Phoenix, Phoenix. Welcome to the streets of Phoenix. Ooh, welcome to the streets of Phoenix, Phoenix. Welcome to the streets of Phoenix. It's that time of the night, we gon' get it started. Just put your hands in the air, come and join the party. You're thinking what you're talking about. Let's have some fun. Here we go. Time to scream and shout. Ooh, welcome to the streets of Phoenix, Phoenix. Welcome to the streets of Phoenix. Ooh, welcome to the streets of Phoenix, Phoenix. Welcome to the streets of Phoenix. Welcome to the streets of Phoenix.